this week is going to be incredibly busy. Not only do I have a cold to battle with and I don't feel that great, I also need to write my talk for New York. I'm going to be there this Friday doing a presentation. I'm going to leave a link in the description below if you want to come out and see it. I'd love to meet you. I gotta start the rescape of the 2,000 gallon aquarium as well, and this is creeping up on me rather fast. All four Asian arowana that are in the 2,000 gallon aquarium are doing awesome. There's no more really any fighting. They're all healing up quite nicely from the initial battles that had ensued once we added the three new Asian arowana, making it four in here. However, they're all eating and doing quite well, telling me that this is going to be successful over time, or at least that's what it's showing me to be. What's going to be interesting though is what comes next. You see, I need to get all the fish out of this tank, and I don't want to do everything in one day, because if you see all of this wood in here, all of this wood got to come out, all of the rocks got to come out, and then all of the plants that are attached to the wood, I got to salvage them somehow. So I think I'm going to take a lot of the plants that are on the wood here and add them to existing aquariums. You know, I think that's going to look really awesome, because this wood's not coming back into the tank once we do a rescape. We're doing a completely different look. And, you know, once I show you what I'm up to, I think the scape's not only going to be just in the aquarium, I think I might add to it above the aquarium as well. So it's almost like, you know, above and below. Maybe, I don't know. I really need your input once this starts to happen, so I do look forward to it. Ultimately though, let's take a closer look at everybody and how they're doing. Now the Bichir is doing really well in here as well. However, I do find that he's more nocturnal, coming out in the evenings when the lights begin to dim. One of the other things I've been wanting to do is kind of switch up the stocking on the 375. Now, I gotta remind you guys, this is a 500 gallon system, including the sump and the volume of water that it's containing. So we have 500 gallons of dilution. Now, when we rescape that 2000, this little ray is going into the 2000, leaving only a handful of rainbow fish left. There's only a handful in here now because, well, this happened. So the Asian aquarium never went according to plan. Basically what happened was, the focus was to set up an Asian themed aquarium, and I ended up buying some clown loaches and clown knife, more of an impulse, but they just so happen to be from Asia. So basically I ended up just throwing them in there. However, a lot of the clown loaches are hiding, and so is the clown knife. The clown knife has several months in there before we can actually move him to the 2000. He will eventually one day go there. However, in the meantime, I want something to fill out the aquarium. That's where... not Rachel. The rainbow come into play. You see, I love the rainbow fish tank. I know many of you guys love it. But I want to utilize it for a different type of aquarium, for a very special fish. Several special fish that are going to be coming soon that I want to put in that tank. And in the meantime, I'm going to take the remaining rainbows
and put them in the Asian tank. Now, I do have Rachel O'Leary here with me. This is kind of like a last minute video, something fun that we could do. Who doesn't like, you know, catching a moving fish and almost setting up a new aquarium? So if you guys don't know Rachel, Rachel actually has her own channel, Invertebrates by Miss Jinx, where she does her own aquarium related videos, focusing on all things nano aquaria. If you're not subscribed to her, I highly suggest you go check her out. Definitely my favorite aquarium channel out there, and I think you guys will enjoy her as well. In the meantime though, here's the plan. We're gonna go ahead and catch all of the rainbows. Then we're gonna move them to the Asian aquarium. I guess that the plan of attack here isn't as complicated as I was thinking in my head. We're just gonna move the fish.
We're just gonna catch them and move them.
Yeah. So Rachel, I'll give you the honor of catching these. We actually made a mistake and fed them earlier. If I didn't feed them earlier, they would all be up at the top waiting to be fed. But Rachel says she can catch them in a matter of minutes, so we'll see what she does. If she doesn't make a mess over here first.
If I don't break anything. Tell you, being out of your own space.
I'll get the rainbow or the Asian tanks ready.
Do you have
ready.
Something you want me to put them in, or do you just...
No, we're just going to transfer. The temperatures of the tanks are going to be similar, and so will the parameters. Every aquarium in here matches. There's three.
Yeah.
Good luck.
You just have to keep running back and forth. It's okay to drip water.
No.
Like I said, if we had just fed them, they'd all be at the top, but I my suggestion would be to just grab them as you can and just keep running them.
I'll just move these over. Yeah.
It's just the same three. Is it four?
Yeah. Or three. I had four, I let them go.
These guys are going to look awesome in here. Anyways, the reds are coming out. And these guys are going to act like a dither fish, encouraging the loaches to come out, just like we're doing with the cardinals and the angel, or the discus, which are a little upset right now. And then, of course, with the emperor tetras, or king tetras, whatever you want to call them, and the waru. So hopefully, we can grab them all.
I was seeing if you had a second net.
I can get a second net for you.
Team, that's it? Are you kidding me? That's even worse. Normally what I do in a situation like this is drain the aquarium down, mm-hmm. and then use one really oversized net in the middle so yeah. that they're all corralled to a side.
Oh yeah.
But that's going to be...
But we don't have time. We've got a matter of
minutes left before we're
not going to be able to film.
I think we're going to have to tag team it.
Gonna have to tag team the tank with Rachel.
Yeah.
I don't know if this can go on YouTube.
Oh, sure. Oh, dear.
You get them? Don't we do it?
Yeah, you wanna give it a try? Yeah. I'd like to see your technique. I'll try and corral them your way.
This could be near impossible.
Do you have a koi sock or anything? Like one of the big ones?
You have a big net, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because then you can set it and then just lift up when we chase them down with the other ones. Try and not stress them too much, but you have to direct them where you want them to go without wrecking the aquarium.
Yeah, all this wood would have to come out. These guys are always so friendly until you get to catch them. I'm not going to be able to do this. I'm going to have to do this another day.
Well, look, the loaches are already up.
Yeah.
Now that Asian tank is kind of turning into like a mix mash of fish, but adding that handful of rainbows over there, and really that's all I could get out of there, you know, it looks like it'd be easy to get them because they all crowd around my hand, but once you put a net in, they dart. However, adding them in, they acted like dither fish. But on the topic of dither fish, which means adding a fish that is far more active than any other fish in the aquarium, almost like a mindless fish, like no matter what's going on outside the aquarium, these guys are typically never going to be skittish or hide, and it allows the other fish to think everything's okay, and they come out more, and that's exactly what we did in the discus tank, and I know a lot of you are starting to notice how much more the discus are coming out more. And I talked about this for, you know, weeks and months that, you know, we just gotta give these guys some time to, get accustomed to the tank and, you know, relax, grow out a little bit, but, you know, everything's going according to plan. However, if you do have, you know, a bunch of fish that are constantly hiding, you know, you might want to go to your local pet store and consider picking up a handful of tetras or a fish that's always going to be out and about. And, you know, that could promote or provoke those skittish fish and those fish that hide all the time to come out more often. Just remember when you do buy your fish to properly quarantine them. Oh, the other thing that I need to get working on this week, probably next week, is the Central American Aquarium that's up top. You guys remember that used to be Frank's tank. Frank's over here now. Boop. But I'd be curious to know what you guys would stock a Central American aquarium if it was yours. 120 gallons, focusing on Central American fish only. Let me know in the comment section what you would stock it with. Anyways, guys, I gotta get over this cold. I don't feel very well. I also gotta write that talk for New York. I only got a few days left to do that, but I know it's gonna be an awesome talk. I got so many cool things I wanna talk about and show you that I've never talked about before. So if you wanna go, you wanna meet, I'll leave a link in the description below. I can't wait to meet you guys.